A B C D E F G H I want A plus English. That's so much fun. English education for you and everyone. So come along. Learn some grammar. Learn a phrase. Learn something new every day. Learn the A plus way.It's time to start the show. Are you ready? Good, cause here we go. A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, I want A plus English.
Cat, what are you doing? We're supposed to be filming today, working, not singing.
Oh, I guess I forgot.
This is not KTV Cat. We can go to KTV after work, I promise.
Okay, actually, though, isn't this an article about KTV?
Okay, I guess you're kind of right, but how about we leave the singing until the end? First, we should read our article about KTV.
Okay, and I guess we gotta ask that warm-up question too, right?
Exactly.
Okay,
let's take the microphone.
Okay.
Let's put that to the side.And then maybe.
I'll be a star one day.
You'll be a star one day. I promise we'll go to KTV tonight and we can have some food and we can sing all the Elton John songs and have an amazing time.
All right. Okay. So what do you like to do with your friends for fun?
Well, other than KTV.
Mm-hmm. Other than KTV.
I like playing video games.
So oh.
I have a Nintendo Switch at home and it's really good for parties.
Like, oh, yeah.
You can have 8 people playing one game, which is super fun.
Oh, that's awesome.
Yeah. What do you like to do?
Well, other than KTV, maybe I like to watch movies or draw, stuff like that. Yeah. There's lots of different fun things you can do with friends.
Especially in Taipei. It's mm-hmm. a city with an endless supply of fun things to do.
That's true.All right, so let's go into our article and find out what Simon and Lucia are up to today. It's our Culture Shock article. Let's see what they're doing.
Culture Shock!
A night at the KTV. Warm-up question. What do you like to do with your friends for fun?
Simon is looking at his phone. He doesn't look happy.
You don't look happy. What's wrong?
My work friends are arranging a karaoke night on Saturday.
That sounds fun.
I hate singing in front of strangers.
But you know all your work friends.
Yeah, but the room is usually full of other people. I tried karaoke a few times in England.
Simon remembers singing badly on stage.
I want to live like common people.
People in the crowd are yelling at him.
Boo!
Rubbish!
Get off!
Simon stops remembering.
It was horrible.
Karaoke isn't like that in Taiwan. We go to a KTV.
A fried chicken shop?
KTV, not KFC. In a KTV, you and your friends have a room to yourselves. You only sing for each other.
There's still one problem, though.
What's that?
I can't sing!
British versus American English.
Rubbish!
You stink! Word power. Arrange. Arrange. Paul and Zelda arranged a time to talk to their son's teacher.Paul and Zelda arranged a time to talk to their son's teacher. Stranger. Stranger. I only saw strangers at the party, not my friends. I only saw strangers at the party, not my friends. Room. Room. My sister and I share a room. We both sleep there. My sister and I share a room. We both sleep there. Horrible. 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 This pizza is horrible. I don't want to eat it. This pizza is horrible. I don't want to eat it.
认识字汇
Karaoke. Fried.
Okay, let's get into our article today.
Yeah.
I'm excited to experience an article set inside of a KTV.
Mm-hmm.
So, we have our two characters, Simon and Lucia. Mm-hmm. And first we have a scenario where Simon is just looking at his phone, he's maybe quite distracted by it, and he doesn't look too happy. And so Lucia says, "You don't look happy. What's wrong?" Oh.
I don't know. Why doesn't he look happy?
I find that that's something that people do nowadays. When they are not feeling happy or they're bored, you know, when you go on the metro, people just look at their phones.
Yeah, but usually their face is just kind of a blank face.
Yeah.
But if you look unhappy, then maybe it's something else.
Oh, maybe he received a bad message.
Well, maybe, and he's gonna say so right now. Mm. So he says, "My work friends are arranging a karaoke night on Saturday." Yay!
Just karaoke.
But he's not happy about that.
Oh, why?
Oh, I don't know. But first we gotta learn what is arrange and what is karaoke, because these are two words we don't exactly know. So let's learn first what arrange means. When we arrange things, this is a verb to talk about putting things together in a neat way, usually. Now, those can be real things, like dishes on a table. If you're trying to set the table for dinner, you will arrange your dishes. Or you might arrange your school papers so they look very nice in your backpack. Or you might even arrange your hair if you want it to look neat and have a style. Or you can talk about arranging ideas and plans. Here, we're talking about plans. So Simon's coworkers are arranging a karaoke night. That means they're making plans to get people together. For arranging plans, you have to think of the time, the place, who's coming, what are you doing, how much money will it cost? That's all part of arranging. Lots of little things to think about. So do you ever arrange parties or movie nights with your friends or maybe even a study group? It doesn't have to be something fun. It just has to be a plan that you are working out the details. So here's an example sentence. Paul and Zelda arranged a time to talk to their son's teacher. So they're arranging a meeting here. Paul and Zelda arranged a time to talk to their son's teacher. All right, so we've learned what arranging means, but what is karaoke or karaoke? It's actually KTV. KTV means karaoke television. KTV, that's the K. So karaoke is actually a Japanese word. Karaoke. It means empty orchestra because it's just the band in the background and then your voice in front of it. But we now use it all over the world and English speakers say karaoke, not karaoke, because I guess we're bad at pronouncing Japanese.
Yes, we are.
Yeah.
Especially me.
Yeah, aw. Except here they call it KTV and I know in Korea they call it norebang, which means singing room.
Ooh, and when I lived in China, they also call it KTV there as
well. Oh, okay, okay. Yeah. So, yeah, maybe every place has their own thing, but in English, we still call it karaoke.
Karaoke, it's a loan word. We took it from Japanese.
Yep.
Well, the article is going to continue, and it's with Lucia, who says, "That sounds fun."
Yeah.
And here we can...
Why is he so sad?
I don't know. It does sound like a fun thing. But we do have an image here, and it's of Simon, and he's shaking his head. He disagrees with Lucia. He doesn't think it sounds fun.
Yeah.
Well, then Simon says, "I hate singing in front of strangers." Well, I kind of agree. Singing in front of strangers can be a very scary thing.
Yeah.
Before we talk about singing in front of strangers, we should probably learn about what a stranger is. So let's learn about this word.
Are you a stranger?
Okay, so the word stranger is a noun, and a stranger is a person that you do not know or recognize. You've never met them before. Many of the people we meet every day are strangers. For example, the people that you see in the street or in the supermarket. They're probably people that you've never seen before, or at least you don't really know them. So an example sentence using stranger would be, I only saw strangers at the party, not my friends.
Got a little stranger danger?
Oh, well, Kat, I hope that you are not a stranger to me.
I don't think so.
No, we're friends now.
We know each other. All right, so going on with the article, you know, Simon says he doesn't like singing in front of strangers. Who does? Except for maybe people who are singers.
Yes.
But Lucia looks kind of confused. She's like, strangers? But you know all your work friends.Yeah, that's true. Simon's going with his work friends. He knows all of them, so why is he talking about strangers?
Right, so yeah, they're not strangers because he knows them, he works with them, maybe he's friends with some of them as well. So why would he feel so worried about singing in front of them?
Yeah, well, maybe he's not thinking about just his friends. Okay.
Well, I think the article will tell us. Simon says, yeah, but the room is usually full of other people.I tried karaoke a few times in England. Well, I'm from England.
And I'm from the US, and we have the same style.
We do, that's right. So I think Simon is a bit confused here. He's going to learn a bit later that maybe there's a difference between how we do karaoke in England and the US and in Taiwan. It's a very different style.
It is, yeah.
Well, first, we do have a word to learn about, and it is the word room. Let's talk about that. Okay, so Simon used the word room here. Room is a noun, and a room is a space inside of a building, usually with four walls and at least one door. Houses usually have many rooms, like a bathroom, living room, and a bedroom.The room that Simon sang in before was probably a big room in a bar or a restaurant, as that's where people usually do karaoke in the UK and in the US. So an example sentence using room would be, My sister and I share a room. We both sleep there. This is a room.
Yes, it is. We're in a room right now.
An underground room. We're giving away the secrets.
Now you know where we are, maybe.
Well, Simon also said that the room was usually full of other people. So what does it mean to be full of something?
Full of food?
Full of, my belly is currently full of dumplings.
Ooh,
delicious. Well, if something is full of something else, that means that that thing has a lot of the other thing inside of it. A few examples might make it clearer. So if you have a bottle with lots of water inside, you can say that that bottle is full of water. If you have a cake that has many pieces of dried fruit inside, you can say that that cake is full of dried fruit.
Okay.
So in the article, Simon was talking about having to sing to a room with many people inside, a room full of people.
Okay. So I imagine a KTV room here andIt's more than just you and your friends, it's other people too.
Right, maybe there are some strangers there. That could be scary.
Yeah, it could be. So that's what Simon is remembering right now. Back in England when he did karaoke, his kind of, you know, the doo-doo-doo-doo dream cloud, he's singing badly on stage. He's singing a song by this band called Pulp, which is a British band from the 90s.I want to live like common people. Isn't that how it goes?
That's the song. I love that song.
I just had to look it up, actually, guys. I didn't know it. But it's a good song. It's got an interesting music video. Anyway, so it's this very well-known song. Maybe a lot of people sing it in karaoke?
In the UK, yes, definitely.
Okay, okay. So in this song, we have this lyric, I wanna live like common people. Wanna? What in that world does that mean? Wanna is actually short for want to. We shorten things like this a lot when we're speaking because we're lazy. We don't wanna say want to, going to, have to. We say wanna, gonna, have to.Shoulda, coulda, woulda, instead of should have, could have, would have. We like to say things a little shorter, a little lazier. So if you wanna say wanna instead of want to when you are speaking, that's perfectly fine. But only in speaking, don't write it. Only use it in speaking. So to learn more about these kinds of shortened words in speaking, let's go to our magic box.
Magic box.
英文当中呢有一些缩读字，缩读字是谁啊？是谁啦？听了不傻傻，但是呢，其实哦，你早就会了。像是呢 ，I am 缩成 I'm， do not cannot 缩写成了 don't can't。OK， 这些呢就是所谓的缩读字了。不过英文里呢还有很多非正式的缩读字哦，看美剧、看电影太常出现了。今天呢，花妈哦就要来帮你整理整理啦。首先呢，这个 don't you 就可以呢缩读为 don't ya。好久以前哦，有这首好红好红的歌哦 ，Don't you wish your girlfriend was hot like me？ 哎呀，你不希望你的女友跟偶一样辣吗？哎呀，不是像花妈啦，是像小野猫可以吗？一样是 cha 结尾的 ，Won't you 就呢可以缩读为 won't cha。这个用法呢就有点邀请的意味在里面了。比方说呢，我们一起去打篮球吗 ？Won't you play basketball with me？你不跟我一起去打球吗？还有呢，一样是 cha 的，还有这个了 ，can cha 就是呢 ，can't you 你不能吗 ？cha 看完了，接下来呢就要看啊，那些有缩读结尾是啊的，其实呢很多都是 to 结尾的，很常会被缩读为啊哦。哪一些呢？比方说像是这个 gotta 呢就是 got to 必须做什么事情的缩读了 ，I gotta。Get up at 5 a.m. to catch the flight. 哇嘛，我要5点起床才赶得上飞机啦。再来呢 ，be going to， 即将要去做什么事情呢？我们就可以缩读为 gonna。I'm gonna finish this Korean TV series tonight. 我今晚呢就要把这一出韩剧给追完了。同系列的呢，还有是一位 wanna 呢就是 want。to 的缩读哦，很常见的呢，还有这个单字哦，就是 wanna be 哦，就表示想达成目标，哎，但是呢，不一定会成功了。比方说呢，这位仁兄呢，哎，很拽哦 ，He is just an actor wanna be， 拽什么啊？他呢，只是一个想当演员的人，根本就还不是演员哦。再来呢，还有这组结尾是 me 的，像是呢这个 lemon 就是 let me 让我来吧。哎呀，比方说呢，很多家庭主妇、哦、都跟花妈一样哦，有一点点点点的这个控制欲啦。我的厨房里面呢，哎，只有我能用。看到阿爸在那里切菜切得乱七八糟，哦，受不了啦。Let me take care of this， 让我来吧。还有呢，这个 give me 就是 give me 给我 ，give me some money 把钱给我。最后补充的这个也是很常见的了，那就是 don't know。don't know 这个字就是 don't know 的缩读 ，I don't know 我不知道。OK， 这些缩读呢很常见，很常听到。不过大家一定要注意，如果是正式写作的话呢，千万别用这些日常口语中才会用到的缩读喽。
All right,、okay. So Simon's singing really badly.
He is singing badly. And then we've got this image of people in the crowd yelling at him and、oh. screaming.、Ooh. And it sounds like they're not very happy with his voice. So they're、yeah. all going,
ah, okay.
You're so bad at this.
Oh my God.、Yeah. So we have different people in the audience. One's going, boo. The next one's going, rubbish. The next one's going, get off.Probably in a British accent, right?
That was a very good British accent.
Oh, thank you.、Mm-hmm. Yeah, so boo, rubbish, get off. And then this first one, why would you say boo? Isn't boo like a ghost noise, like a boo?
Ah, well, it can be, but it can、mm. also be a different kind of word.
Right, so actually boo can be a noise that you make either to scare people or it's telling people you strongly disagree with them or you think they're terrible on stage. So when you're at a concert and there's lots of people around you,You can't say to the person, you're very bad at singing. They won't hear you. So、mm-hmm. all you can do is boo. Yeah, so booing is really rude. But sometimes when you're in a crowd, it's the only way to show you don't like what's happening.、Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Yeah, I've never、mm-hmm. booed somebody. I think it's a little bit rude.
I've only booed my friends for fun.
For fun, yeah.
like, boo, you stink. You
yeah,、
know?
Yeah, just for making fun.
Yeah.、
But we also had another word here, which was rubbish. And...As this one's a very British expression,、mm-hmm. I think I'll take this one.
You go for it.
Rubbish literally means trash or garbage, you know,、Ooh. Things that you throw away,、mm-hmm. Which are the words more commonly used in American English, meaning something you don't need anymore.
Yeah.、
We actually say rubbish bin instead of trash can in British English.
Yeah.
Here, however, rubbish is used to mean something else a little bit different. We can call something that we don't like or something that is bad, silly, or boring rubbish. It's not a very polite thing to say, though. You can describe anything as rubbish, really. You could say, I've had a rubbish day today, which means that your day was not good. Or, I thought that this movie was rubbish. You really didn't enjoy watching that movie.
Yeah.
It's a very British way of expressing your dislike of something.
Yeah, and I think in the US we would say something similar. We'd say, that was trash, that was terrible, that was garbage. Yeah, for sure.
Well, the article continues here with some more negative words. Simon says, it was horrible. I mean,
getting booed by people would be horrible.
Yes, it's a very horrible experience. An experience like that would make me be scared of singing in front of people too.
Yep.
So horrible, by the way, is an adjective and it's a very strong word. Let's talk about that. If something is described as horrible, it means that it is very, very bad. But what kind of bad? Something can taste horrible, that means it's disgusting to eat. Something can sound horrible, that means it's bad to listen to. A place can be horrible too, and that might mean that the place is dirty or dangerous. A person can also be horrible, that means that they are not a very kind or nice person. So horrible isn't a very specific adjective, as it doesn't tell us exactly what is bad about the thing, just that it is very, very bad. So an example sentence using horrible would be, this pizza is horrible, I don't want to eat it.
All right, so obviously if Simon has sang in front of people before and he got booed, he would be afraid of singing at KTV here.
Yes, he might not want to do it again.
Yeah, but Lucia has some good news for him. She says, karaoke isn't like that in Taiwan. We go to a KTV. Okay, and Simon looks kind of confused. A KTV?
Okay.
Well, he asks what that could possibly mean. KTV, if you don't know what it means, maybe you would think it sounds like KFC.
Ooh, yes. Is he going to make a mistake?
I think he is, because he's a very silly boy. All right, Simon says, a fried chicken shop? Yep. So fried here is, you know, talking about a kind of food. When you fry food, you put it in a bath of hot oil, usually after you put bread on it, and it makes it delicious and crispy. And fried chicken is the thing KFC and TKK sell. That's what it is. It's delicious, it's not very good for you, and it's also not KTV. Yeah, so...
Very different things.
Yeah, so...
Although you might be able to get fried chicken in KTV.
You can, yes. Often you can. So Lucia says... She's laughing. She says, KTV, not KFC. In a KTV, you and your friends, this is her talking, have a room to yourselves. You only sing for each other.
Okay, so that's the difference between maybe Taiwanese-style KTV and karaoke that we're used to in the UK and US.
Yes, we usually have karaoke bars.
Yes, so you're singing to a huge room full of people that maybe you know, but many people that are strangers that you don't know.
Yeah.
That's why maybe it's a scarier experience.
So once you sing, you have the room to yourself, it's kind of the opposite. It means you're the only one who gets to use it or to be there. If you tell your friend like, oh, I have the house to myself today, it means you're at the house by yourself. You have all the time, you can enjoy your free time by yourself. It's really nice because sometimes you just want to be alone. So in KTV, it's the same thing. Only you and your friends are in the room. It's not a bunch of strangers.
Yeah, I like that. It feels more private and intimate. It's a good way of singing.
Yeah.
So the article continues, and first we've got a picture of Simon who is thinking about this. He's maybe thinking about the differences between his karaoke and KTV. And then he says, there's still one problem though.
What's that? Lucia asks him.
And Simon says, I can't sing.
Well, we kind of saw that in his memory, but that doesn't matter. You can go to KTV and maybe you're a terrible singer, but we're going to find out what they do tomorrow. So let's go ahead and wrap up this day one. We'll see in day two if they're going to go to KTV. So let's go ahead and go to our review time.
Review time.
Okay, our review time game today is a pretty fun one, and it will help you with pronunciation, which is how you say words. So we're playing the whisper game.
Ooh, I like this one.
Yes, it's a game that I got from YouTube. YouTubers like to do this. What you do is you have one person wearing headphones or plugging their ears so they can't hear, and the other person is whispering a word to them or a sentence. So let's see if you're any good at this.
Okay, so I need to guess the word that you're saying.
Yes,
I can't.
You're looking at my mouth, but you can't hear me.
Okay, so lip reading.
Yes, lip reading.
I'm plugging my ears now.
Okay, look at me.
Orange? Are you saying orange like a fruit?
No.
No, okay. Okay, so this is one of our word power words. I think you're saying the word arrange.
I am saying arrange.
Yes.
Good job.
Really, right. Really, really looks like orange.
It does, doesn't it?
Now I want an orange.
All right. All right, shall I?
Yes, I'll try
one. You give me one.
Okay, let's give you a word. Let's give you a word with more syllables. Okay, how about this one? I'm gonna make a sentence.
I can hear you actually.
Okay.
Do I love the ball?
You are horrible.
You are horrible.
Yes!
Oh my god, you called me horrible.
I don't mean that, Kat. You're lovely.
Oh, thanks.
I just had to use that word.
Yeah, you are horrible. That is horrible. All right, I think that's all the time we've got. You guys can see how this game works. Try and use your pronunciation. English uses lots of mouth muscles,
yes.
So you can really use your mouth and try and play this game.
Try it at home.
All right, we'll see you for day two and find out what Simon and Lucia are up to. Bye bye.
Bye.
Culture Shock.
A night at the KTV. Warm-up question.What do you like to do with your friends for fun?
Simon is looking at his phone. He doesn't look happy.
You don't look happy. What's wrong?
My work friends are arranging a karaoke night on Saturday.
That sounds fun.
I hate singing in front of strangers.
But you know all your work friends.
Yeah, but the room is usually full of other people. I tried karaoke a few times in England.
Simon remembers singing badly on stage.
I want to live like common people.
People in the crowd are yelling at him.
Boo! Rubbish!
Get off!
Simon stops remembering.
It was horrible.
Karaoke isn't like that in Taiwan. We go to a KTV.
A fried chicken shop?
KTV, not KFC. In a KTV, you and your friends have a room to yourselves. You only sing for each other.
There's still one problem, though.
What's that?
I can't sing!
British versus American English.
Rubbish!
You stink! Word power. Arrange. Arrange.Paul and Zelda arranged a time to talk to their son's teacher. Paul and Zelda arranged a time to talk to their son's teacher. Stranger. Stranger. I only saw strangers at the party, not my friends. I only saw strangers at the party, not my friends.Room, room. My sister and I share a room. We both sleep there. My sister and I share a room. We both sleep there. Horrible, 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 horrible. This pizza is horrible. I don't want to eat it. This pizza is horrible. I don't want to eat it.
认识字汇
Karaoke Fried